In this video, we're going to finish up with the trigonometry and area worksheet on the CUDA software website under the geometry section. Our directions for this next part are to find the area of each regular polygon and to round our answer to the nearest tenth. Now, if you remember from a previous worksheet or a previous lesson that the area of a regular polygon is equal to 1/2 of the apothem times the perimeter. And the apothem is from the center of that polygon perpendicular to a side. Now in number 9, we need to figure out exactly what the apothem is. And if this is a trigonometry and area worksheet, here's a little hint, we're going to be using a trig function. Now let's think about how we would use a trig function to calculate the apothem. Notice that I can break this 9-sided figure up into 9 congruent triangles. And we're given that the perimeter is 108 miles. And if there's 9 sides, remember the perimeter P is equal to the number of sides N times that side length S. So if the perimeter in this figure is 108 miles, and it's a 9-sided figure, we're going to need to solve for the side length S. So dividing both sides by 9, 108 divided by 9 will give us 12. So a side length S is 12. And the number of sides that is represented by variable N is 9. So if S is 12 and N is 9, our perimeter 12 times 9 is 108. So this side length is congruent to all the other side lengths of 12. So that means that if we were to draw the apothem, like I have highlighted as the red line, the apothem is perpendicular and will bisect that segment. Therefore, the side is broken in half, so this measurement is 6, because 6 and 6 equal 12. So we have one side length. We're trying to solve for the apothem, so let's calculate an angle. And then we can use tangent with opposite over adjacent and calculate that adjacent side. So remember, this is split into 9 congruent triangles, and you can see that this is a 360 degree circle in the middle. So that circle is split into 9 congruent angles. So if we take 360 degrees and divide that by the number of sides N, that's going to be 360 degrees divided by 9, which is equal to 40 degrees. So one angle is 40 degrees. However, that apothem bisects that angle, so we want half of that angle, which is 20 degrees. Now let's use tangent to solve for the apothem. The tangent of that 20 degree angle equals the opposite side length, 6, over the adjacent side length, which is our apothem, we'll call x. So now what we're going to do is multiply both sides by x in order to get the x out of the denominator, and then we're going to divide 6 by the tangent of 20 degrees. So x is equal to 6 over the tangent of 20 degrees. Making sure our calculator is in degree mode, we get 16.48. So that's 16.485. So if we take that number, which is our apothem, multiply it by a perimeter of 108, and by 1/2, we'll get the area. So A equals 1/2 times our apothem of 16.485 times our perimeter of 108, which will give us 890.19, which rounds to 0.2. And since we're using miles, the area is miles squared. Now, that seems like a lot of work for one problem, but let's look closer at this formula for area and figure out a standard formula that we can use for all regular polygons. So area equals 1/2 of our apothem times our perimeter, which our perimeter is simply N times S, where N is the number of sides and S is the length of one of those sides. Now, for the apothem, we use tangent to solve. Now let's think about this. The tangent of that angle of 20 degrees which we can write as 180 degrees divided by the number of sides n. And remember, that's because we took 360, divided that by n, and then we took half of that. So we did 360 divided by n, and then multiplied that by 1/2. So that would give us 180 divided by n. And remember, 180 divided by n, in this case, it was 180. We divided that by 9 and got 20 degrees. So in general, we take 180 and we divide it by the number of sides n. That will give us half of one of these angles that connect in the center. And the tangent of that angle is equal to the opposite over the adjacent. The adjacent we know is our apothem. And what exactly was opposite? Well, opposite was half of that side length, s. And these s's, the s that we have for our perimeter and the s that we have in this current equation, are the same. So if we multiply both sides by the apothem, which we used as x, then that apothem was equal to 1/2 of s divided by the tangent of 180 over n. And that's the same as s over 2 times the tangent of 180 over n. That is our apothem. So we'll plug that in for our equation. So we'll have s over 2 times the tangent of 180 over n. And again, since 1/2 is multiplied to s, I just put the 2 in the denominator of the entire equation. So we have s over 2, which is the same as 1/2 times s. And remember that 1/2 s was divided by the tangent of that angle. So now we have a general formula for finding area. So let's rewrite our formula for number 10. We have area equal to 1/2 of our apothem, which our apothem is the side length s divided by 2 times the tangent of 180 over the number of sides n of that regular polygon, and that is multiplied by the perimeter, which is n times s. So let's fill in number 10. Area is equal to 1/2. A side length is 10 kilometers over 2 times the tangent of 180 divided by n, which this is a triangle, so that is 3. And that will get multiplied to 3 times that side length of 10, since 3 times 10 will be the perimeter of this triangle. So let's simplify and solve. We'll have 1/2 times, and this will be 10 divided by 2, so we can simplify that to 5, over the tangent of 180 divided by 3, which is the tangent of 60 degrees. And that gets multiplied to 3 times 10, which is 30. So let's go ahead and enter this into our calculator. We'll do 1/2 times, putting in parentheses, 5 over the tangent of 60 degrees. Remember to surround this 5 divided by the tangent of 60 degrees in parentheses. And then we'll multiply that by 30. That will give us 43.30, which rounds to 43.3, and since our side length is kilometers, for area, we'll have kilometers squared. And if you want to simplify 1/2 times 5 divided by the tangent of 60 degrees times 30 even more, we can combine 1/2 with 5 and 30. Since 1/2 of 30 is 15, and 15 times 5 is 75. So we can write this as 75 divided by the tangent of 60 degrees. And 75 divided by the tangent of 60 degrees is indeed 43.3. Let's move on to number 11. For number 11, they already calculate the perimeter out, but let's count the number of sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the number of sides n is 12. And the perimeter, n times s, is equal to 144, and that's centimeters. Remember, in our area formula, a equals 1/2 of our apothem, which is the side length s, over 2 times the tangent of 180 over n, and then we multiply that to the perimeter, which is n times s. So we have 1/2 our side length s. We can calculate by dividing the perimeter by the number of sides n. And if n is 12, 144 divided by 12 will give us that S is also 12. So we have N, S, and we have the perimeter N times S. So 1 half times 12 over 2 times the tangent of 180 degrees divided by the number of sides 12. That gets multiplied to our perimeter of 144. So let's simplify this first. 12 over 2 is 6. So we'll have 1 half times 6 times 144, which is 432. And that will get divided by the tangent of 180 divided by 12. So the tangent of 15 degrees. 432 divided by the tangent of 15 degrees is equal to 1612.24, which rounds to 1612.2. And since our sine length is centimeters for area, we'll have centimeters squared. Continuing on to number 12, the number of sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. N is 6, and our side length, S, is 9 centimeters. So let me write the area formula for you again. Area equals 1 half of our apothem, which is the side length, divided by 2 times the tangent of 180 over N. And that gets multiplied to our perimeter of S times N. 1 half the apothem times the perimeter. That is area. So let's plug in what we know. We have 1 half, our side length is 9, and we're dividing that by 2 times the tangent of 180 over the number of sides N, which is 6, since this is a hexagon, and that will get multiplied to the perimeter of 6 times 9. So let's go ahead and simplify this. Let's multiply the numerators, and we'll multiply the denominators. So we can think of 6 times 9 as 6 times 9 over 1. So 2 times 2 is 4. So in our denominator, we'll have 4 times the tangent of 180 over 6, which is the tangent of 30 degrees. And multiplying our numerators, 1 times 9 times 6 times 9 is 486. So now let's simplify. 486 divided by 4 times the tangent of 30 degrees. And remember, we're dividing by the quantity 4 times the tangent of 30 degrees. And that is equal to 210.44, which rounds to 210.4. And our side length is centimeters, so area is centimeters squared. Now quickly, I want to show you that we could also simplify this area formula further. I like leaving it as 1 half the apothem times the perimeter, but you can multiply the numerators together and the denominators together to get an even simpler formula. Multiplying the numerators, we'll get 1 times S times S times N. So that's going to be S squared times N divided by, now let's multiply the denominator. 2 times 2 is 4. And we're multiplying that by the tangent of 180 over N. So we can write area also as S squared times N over 4 times the tangent of 180 divided by N. And you can see that that is a much simpler formula than what I have written out, although logically it helps me remember that I'm multiplying 1 half of the apothem times the perimeter. So feel free to simplify the formula if you want to. Now for number 13, we have a regular hexagon with a perimeter of 48 yards. So area equals 1 half the apothem, which is S over 2 times the tangent of 180 over N, times our perimeter, S times N. Well, if our perimeter is 48 yards, and it's a hexagon, the number of sides is 6. So S times N is S times 6. So let's calculate the length of one side. Since N is 6, we'll divide the perimeter by 6. 48 divided by 6 is 8, so I'll get that 8 yards is equal to a side length, S. So I'll plug in S and N into my area formula. So that'll be 1 half of our side length of 8 over 2 times the tangent of 180 divided by the number of sides N, which we have as 6 since this is a hexagon, and then we're multiplying that by our perimeter. So because I left my area formula as 1 half times the apothem times the perimeter, as opposed to simplifying it, I can just plug in 48, since they give me the perimeter. Now let me simplify. 2 times 2 in the denominator is equal to 4. So I'll have 8 times 48 all over 4 times the tangent of 180 divided by 6, which is 30 degrees. And 4 goes into 8 evenly. That's 2 times. So for my numerator, as opposed to having 8 times 48 and then dividing that by 4 times the tangent of 30, I'll just have 2 times 48 over the tangent of 30 degrees. And 2 times 48 is 96, and when I divide that by the tangent of 30 degrees, I get 166.27, which rounds to 166.3, and since the side length is in yards, my area will be yards squared. So 166.3 yards squared is the area of a regular hexagon with a perimeter of 48 yards. Now lastly, number 14. In number 14, we have a regular pentagon, so n is equal to 5, and we have 6 feet for the side length, so s is equal to 6. And we're talking about feet, so we know that our area will be feet squared. So let's use our simplified area formula. Remember, it was area equals s squared times n all over 4 times the tangent of 180 divided by n. 1/2 the apothem times the perimeter simplified. So let's plug in s and n into our equation. So we'll have 6 squared times n, which is 5, all over 4 times the tangent of 180 divided by n, which is 5. 6 squared is 36, and when we multiply that by 5, we get 180. So 180 divided by 4 times the tangent of 180 divided by 5, which is the tangent of 36. And I know that 4 goes into 180 evenly, and that's 45 times. So 180 divided by 4 is 45, and we're dividing that by the tangent of 36 degrees. So 45 divided by the tangent of 36 degrees will give us our final solution, which is 61.93, which rounds to 61.9, and that was feet squared for area. So 61 9/10 feet squared is our last solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions or need a further explanation of the area of a regular polygon, just leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Also, if you haven't already, like, subscribe, and share.